Okay, just a disclaimer. I am by no means a professional, and you should definitely look at other options for stargazing. So, you know. Okay? Good, let's go. Today I wanted to show off a telescope that I've been eyeing on and finally got a hold of. It's called the Celestron Astromaster LT76AZ, I think. It's a reflector telescope. It's very user-friendly, and overall, I like it. It's a very nice scope. Now, I did buy it off of Amazon, and I know the Celestron website also sells it for the same price of $139. It's by no means a cheap telescope, but you know, for what it's capable of, plus the accessories you can get on the Celestron website to go with it, it's very worth it, I'd say. Like I said before, the telescope is a reflector, so if you're looking for a refractor, aka those other ones that people usually want, because it's got the big tube, not the thick tube, the big tube, the long tube. So yeah, if you want the long tube, I would look into the AZ70 or 60. But if you don't care or prefer reflectors, then this is the one for you. Now, when you open the main box, you'll see four other boxes inside. There's these two big ones and these two smaller ones. This one is kind of just for filling space. I have no clue why it's even here. The other small one contains the viewfinder, star pointer thingy, with a battery already inside, and the 10 and 20 millimeter lenses. Now, the bigger boxes. The smaller one has the actual scope itself, while the bigger one holds the tripod and the accessory tray. And really, that's all you need, and that's all that's inside, apart from the CD manual and quick step guide. First, you need to unscrew and loosen these turny things and pop the legs out. And they should slide out and, you know, stop once fully extended. They're made of steel, but they aren't super strong. Just remember, it's a telescope and not a WWE folding chair.
Mira algo en la calle 34, te dije que me sonaba lucha callejera. Te lo dije, Carlitos.
Con regalos incluidos.
Me sonaba lucha callejera.
Mira qué buen regalito encontró.
Once that's done, screw these little turny bits tight again and prop it for tripod. You also can add the accessory tray now by lining the hole with the groove in the center, pressing it down and turning it so the embossed edges line up with the legs. Remember that if you want to take your scope on the go, it's best to remove this by doing the same steps backwards, so you can fold the legs again. Then, giving this little turny turn a thing, a little bit of a lefty-loosey, you can now put the big tube of far seeing in. Just attach the scope and tighten the bolt to secure it. And the tripod also has another one which you use to tighten or loosen the horizontal movement of your scope using the pan handle. And using said pan handle, it will make you feel like an awesome cameraman. You're basically done, but now you still have the viewfinder, which instead of using a iron sight, cross sight thing, you now just have this little laser point that you use. For this, I recommend using a Phillips head, but I'm pretty sure that the screws also work with a flathead, as long as it's thin enough. Now you just need to partially unscrew the two bottom screws. Don't fully unscrew them, I had to learn that the hard way and put it back together. And basically just slide the little tiny viewfinder onto the actual scope's rail on the other side of where you put the lenses in. When setting up, you preferably want to pick any sort of object around you in at least a quarter of a mile distance away, but as long as it's clear, it should be fine. In this case, I used a doorknob on a house across the street. Once you picked your object and pointed your telescope at it so you see it in the middle of your lens, you can then go to your viewfinder. This knob controls turning the laser right or left, and this one naturally goes up and down. Using these knobs, you shine the laser onto the object you used, and your viewfinder should be ready for use. And apart from any accessories, you get this. It stands around 4 to 5-ish feet and you look through the side. Now, if you complain, I swear to God, if you actually complain about the view being upside down, I'm sorry, that's just how telescopes work, this one specifically. If you wanted something right set up, I would suggest a refractor, because, you know, mirrors are a bitch. You also have the dust cap up front with another little tiny dust cap on the dust cap. Just keep both dust caps, the one that you put on the lens and the one that you actually put on the front end. It just makes things easier. Anyway, why would I make this video? Well, today is my birthday, and I'm bored and fresh back from COVID, and I absolutely love space. If you have any feedback or just have any questions, feel free to ask me in the comments. And if you want more content like this, consider subscribing and joining my Discord in the description. That place needs some life sprung into it. Anyway, I hope you enjoy your new telescope and have a good night stargazing.